You're watching UNICEF Television.
In presenting the UNICEF programs for Libya and Sudan, Director of Programs Nicholas Alipui outlined how UNICEF is going to meet the different challenges facing each.
The program focuses on three strategic areas. One, education, namely the quality of basic education and the expansion of access to preschool in partnership with the European Union. Two, protection, focusing on the alignment of national legislation with the standards of international conventions and the establishment of monitoring mechanisms for child rights. Three, strengthening systems for data collection and analysis to more effectively inform policy and policymakers. This combination of strategies takes into account the financial resources available to government and will focus on capacity building, leveraging partnerships, and making the case for targeted investments to improve the quality and reach of services, and brokering international high-level expertise. This is not only a time of change in Libya, it is also a time of unprecedented opportunity. The country has the potential to build foundations for long-term development and improvements in well-being. This can only be reached through a sustained investment in children and a new social commitment built on equity and human rights. There are still 3,200,000 children, 6 to 16 years old, who are out of school in Sudan. The acute malnutrition level among children aged 0 to 3 years is above the internationally agreed emergency threshold, which means that almost 500,000 children a year are at this critical threshold. Serious protection issues prevail, such as child marriages, female genital mutilation and cutting, and others. Higher budgetary allocations are needed, therefore, in these critical areas of programmatic work. The draft program before you will move Sudan closer to achieving the Millennium Development Goals. Building on the experience of UNICEF's long-term partnership in Sudan, it gives heightened importance to strategies that prevent and address malnutrition and its determinants, and expand quality and access to basic education, health, water, sanitation, and protection, as well as upstream policy work, will remain a high priority for UNICEF in the Sudan.
You've been watching UNICEF Television. For more information, visit unicef.org.
You've been watching UNICEF Television.